Hello, and welcome to the second of our films for South Denial. I'm here in Jamaica, part of the Caribbean Territory. Today, I'm at the Salvation Army School for Blind and Visually Impaired Children, and I'm meeting Salvation Army Officer Nicola Muir, who's been living and working here for the last 3 years.
Want to see around the school?
The school was established in 1927.
Has come from England, okay?
And today there are 90 students here. Most of them, like Shamor and Shoshana, are boarders. The school is the only one of its kind in the country and looks after students from age 3 to 20.
It's a phenomenal experience. It's hard work, it's long hours, it's frustrating, but it's very rewarding. It's frustrating because there is so much more that could be done. But the children are so rewarding and so loving and so caring that it's great to be here.
Right, so we're going to go into the classroom where Ms. Thompson is teaching Braille to some of the students.
Braille is one of the specialist subjects taught here, and it's on the timetable alongside all the other more conventional subjects.
What do you think is so important about the children learning Braille? What difference does it make?
For the children, it gives them independence as well, a form of being able to read and write other than script and other than the computer. There are lots of books in Braille and the Bible's in Braille, so it does give them an independence as well.
Always have them with .5 in front of it. All right, the UAB, the new Braille system, it's different. So it's .5 and lower S. So let's write a problem.
Miss,
15 plus 13.
Some students here have been completely blind from birth. This is probably the only school they will ever go to. Others may have lost their sight more recently or are losing their sight. So the classes support children at all stages. With practice, a good Braille reader can read Braille as quickly as the average able-sighted person can read text. But for students who are new to Braille, it's like learning a new language.
Miss, what is R again?
1, 2, 3, and 5. Yeah. Miss, what is that? All right? No, feel it. Hold on, feel it yourself.
The majority of my 70 boarders are from a very low social economical background. A lot of them come from very rural communities, and so they literally almost live and eat hand to mouth.
The school provides wholesome meals every day for all the students. And over lunch, I had a chat with one of the partially sighted students called Mikhail.
Sometimes I accidentally fall while not looking where I'm going.
Yeah.
Because I only can see a little bit.
How can I help you?
Well, sometimes for the people who are fully blind, and the kids who can see poorly, you have to guide the blind kids.
That's great, so you help each other out. Have you learned Braille yet?
Yes.
Yes? What's it like?
It's really fun. All you just need to do is tap on different keys, and then when you press the space key in the middle, bop, the shade just come out, and then I can see the Braille.
You're brilliant. Can I get a high five?
High five!
High five!
Yeah! Here we go. And over here too.
This afternoon, we are back with Mrs. Thompson. She's training her class in cane work. Some of the children are being blindfolded.
Mrs. Thompson, can you tell me why you're blindfolding some of them?
Oh, because I want them to do it with the vision, the little vision they have, because some of them, they are low vision, right? So I practice them with the little vision they have, and I practice them without, because some of them are losing the vision itself.
Okay.
So I have to know to use it.
That makes sense.
Right.
Does it make it a little bit more difficult?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'll close the head, child, because I don't want to touch your eyes directly, all right?
Relax, child, we need to go across it, all right? Relax.
Thompson is teaching the diagonal cane technique. It's a basic method which doesn't involve tapping or swinging the cane. It's only used in familiar, controlled environments, so the school grounds are perfect. It takes a lot of practice, but the idea is the students will gain confidence moving around spaces that they know well and can negotiate unexpected objects. Or each other. In next week's film, I'm at the William Chamberlain Centre, and I'll be handing out some rather tasty-looking chicken and rice.